Listen to them. Children of the night. What music they make.
Beloved by the night.
I'll kill you and the night!
I bid you welcome.
Alright. Time for us to head into the Dark Palace of Waterfalls. Which is section 4 over here. So things are gonna get a whole lot rough now. Yep, this place is filled with everything. Goddamn mermen, lizards, and all types of aquatic monsters. But luckily, you have the lightning whip, so. Oh, now you give me a rosary, really? Ooh, small meat. You know what, since stuff here is using ice, I'll use the Arctic Ring. This place is like one big ass labyrinth. But we can get through this, no prob. Turn this on. Makes it a lot harder for them to get the drop on me. Splinters off into two paths. Alright, cool, now I got the rising shot combo fully. You guys are back. Alright, Harbor Crate, that's good. Yeah, I saw you. Half splits off yet again. That's the map. Oh, the other way's a save room. Cool. Get out of my way. I'm just gonna do a combo. There you go. That normally does an ass load of damage. Save a bunch just for safety's sake. Ass. Alright, Marker Stone 8. I can't come over here just yet. us into the basement area. Essentially, I gotta get the bridge open. Now I can refill my hearts on my. Thanks to the heart repairs I got from the flea men. And speak of flea men, and I shall get jumped. Ah, shit. Frost demons, so fireworks exceptionally well against them. That just relinks itself back to the other hall, so. Actually, let's go this way in case there's a save room on the side. Alright, we're good, we made it. Halfway on this side. Oh, and there's a door covered by ice, which we can break. So we just get a bunch of cash every time I hit things with my whip. I also gotta be careful because I know there's some fake walls in some of these areas. I can just farm some cash. I hate these old things. How many hearts I get off of a heart repair? Because I got plenty. That is good, Chunk. Nice. I must say, this part may be, maybe well over an hour. Especially since I got a freaking, fight and kill Yakim. Alright, so... Oh, jeez, everything veers off. We didn't even get to the sub boss yet. Wait, is that a save room? It is. Because there's an actual sub boss, and then... And then there's the main boss. Oh, speaking of the sub boss, here he is. It is the doppelganger. Yep, so he has our combos as well. And he flees. So we're not gonna see him till later on. Yeah, that fight's actually pretty rough on crazy mode. Which is this game's hard mode equivalent. Because you have to fight two of them in that room. Okay, that's the waterfall. So that means I need to switch the water around. Once I do that, we're good. Yeah, this place is confusing because I gotta switch the water pressure around and then I gotta... Ah! Outta here. Now that's the save room, I don't need it right now. Alright, I need to go back to the other fork in the road. Is this it? Yep, just a path. I must have heard something big coming around, say, what the hell? And I need the black key for this door so I can't open it. Definitely dodged it. Yeah, it's fine because I have potions. Okay, keep hitting it. Alright, now that changed the water pressure. Well, not the pressure, but it changed the flow. So that means I can expect that other door now. Can't see anything in front of me. All right, get out of here. Oh, this game could benefit from a lock-on system so bad. Alright. I'll say that. I will take that max health up. Whatever makes me stronger, and alright. Gotta wish I could rotate the camera. Guess I'm not getting snuck on by any enemies. And I gotta go. Wait, I came in that way. Yeah, that's the basement door. So, all right, good. Alright, I'm in the way I need to go. Wait, how do you change this map to free mode? Rotate mode. Cool. Now I better know where I'm going. Alright, next Castlevania, they definitely need to add a mini map. Like in the corner somewhere. Alright, but the water should be gone from this door. Oh, I noticed. We gotta hit the lamps. And you still gotta hurry up and access the room, even though you hit everything. Oh, blue dragon key. Alright, that's cool. That's back at the gardens. So, am I done everything down here then? Yeah, because the black key's down there. The water flow's taken care of. Alright. Gotta come through here. This little, death game. I'm just taking the damage because I don't want to miss the coins. We're good, because we should get the relic now. Oh no, so, max out. And save room's like literally right here. Okay, so we can't go back that way anymore because the waterway's being blocked, so now I gotta take the long way around. Yeah, I'm only really fighting enemies when I have to. Oh, and this is the drawbridge. All Alright, so that's been triggered. So now we can actually go take on the boss. Which is the minions on the other side. Of all the stuff we avoided. Make sure I'm hitting the right way. Just get some energy. Yep, because unless I'm specifically blocked, there's no point to fight and kill. Outside of unlocking moves, I don't get anything else. That's good, it refills my MP meter. I really wish there was a way to quick swap the whips. Alright, normal door, and... what are you? Oh. I know how to do this. I gotta lure this guy over here. Yep, and I know exactly where we're at. Any reason for me to be down here? Alright, so jump up here. Being on the lookout because I know there's like some things hitting around. Oh, I see it. Got whoop up here. Jump up. Do it again. Yep, so you jump across to that area, come over here, whip up, grab the super potion, put the whip of flame on, trust me on this. If you miss a jump, you gotta start over, so be careful. Let's go in this door first. And this is the HP max out. Cool. That's another rod. We're gonna wait to do that. Cause I have to trek my way all the way back. Made it. Alright. One more. Nice. And here comes the boss. Fire and Lightning have been killed. Time to finish off the little sister. The Ice Elemental. And if it's apparent yet, she's extremely weak to fire. Oh, crap! And with the Ice Elemental's death, beckons us a new power. It's the power of ice. Now we got ice. And that's all the elementals taken care of. They're all dead. And now we're gonna take this little ride. Same as before, just go to left and right. I don't think there's any in the middle. Like I said, I don't care, I'm gonna take the damage. These cold things don't even hurt enough. And we're good. And we got the meditative essence. Hearts recover gradually. So that's her relic. But because we did that, we have to make our way all the way back from the basement. Yes, like I said, this area is long. Ah, you son of a... I'm away. And despite having the ice whip, don't use it. Because everything here is pretty damn immune to it. Ah, I should be careful not to run through here like that. Keep straight. Fork in the road. Oh, what the heck? Oh, it put me behind the Oh, I never did. I just never went that way. Oh, I just blocked out the path I couldn't go to. Never mind. Oh, that's what I did wrong. I went the wrong way. I have to take the other path and back through the basement. Where's that skull room at? Yeah, that's why I need to get back to the first floor. Oh, that recovery on the heart tank isn't that bad. That's actually pretty neat. These axes, because these things hurt like crazy. All right, we're good. And unfortunately, there's no way to, like, move quicker in this area. I mean, technically, I kid if I have the wolf's foot relic, which makes me run faster. Hit the save room and top off my health. Well, like I said, it's not worse than Curse of Darkness, navigating around two places. Because the hallways are, like, way too dang long. Now I gotta make this unnecessary long loop back around. Alright, and just the door on my right. And I gotta... Once I hit the fork in a row, go down. Yeah, forgive me for constantly checking the map, but... With the layout and the camera angles, you can just wind up running in circles and not even know it. And we just keep straight ahead now. That lightning whip is no joke. And it gets even better once we get the vampire killer. Is there anything down here? Alright, nothing of importance. Ah, Jesus. I hate the timing off on this. Yeah, be careful because them damn goat things are going to attack you while you're in the move. Alright, almost done. And, oh, god damn it. Made it. And this is a hard up. Yep. All right, now we're at the boss. On the ground way here, right? Nope. And that's the reason why you had to change the water to get access to this door in the first place. So that's good, and we have access to the drawbridge. Alright, time to fight the boss. Alright, potions are slotted. I got the Whip of Lightning, which I believe is his weakness. I have the Arctic Ring going around too, right? Yeah, because I think he does ice damage. Alright, let go.
Is someone there? Are you a prisoner here?
My name is Leon. too bad you aren't Walter.
This feeling. Are you a vampire?
That's right, lonely human.
Why is a vampire locked away here?
Shut up! Damn, Walter. I would have won were it not for his ebony stone.
Ebony stone? What's that?
If you want to know. Beat me! It'll be a nice prelude to defeating Walter.
Alright. Time to take on Hakeem Monster. So before we can even hurt him, we need to, well, dodge his attacks and knock out these lights in the arena. Ah, fuck. And not take too much damage doing so. So, that's all he's literally going to do is protect these lights and try to kill you. You do get ample time to get around to avoid them. Yeah, try not to do it as risky as I am.
Answer me, what is the ebony stone?
A stone made with alchemy. It creates the never-ending darkness in this forest.
Hence eternal night. But the night should help you as well, since you're a vampire.
That stone chooses its master. My powers pale beside his. Oh, if only I had the crimson stone!
Alright, and that's the end of Hakeem. With his death, we attained the green orb. Come to daddy.
The Crimson Stone. He mentioned alchemy. Perhaps Ronaldo might know something.
No, someone was keeping watch. But yep, that's the entire point of this area, was to keep him imprisoned.
I have a question, Ronaldo.
Don't you always? Ask away.
The ebony and crimson stones.
What about them?
You knew about them. Why didn't you tell me?
How would that have changed anything? The night still wouldn't have ended.
True, but...
Well... I would have told you. I shall tell you now.
Please.
Have you ever heard of the Philosopher's Stone?
No, I haven't.
Making the Philosopher's Stone is the ultimate goal of alchemy. It provides eternal youth. The two other stones were apparently created accidentally. No details of how they were made remain now.
I see. I know about the Ebony Stone, but what kind of power does the Crimson Stone have?
I don't know the details. It turns the souls of vampires into power for its master. These two stones are the vampire's greatest treasures.
Wouldn't the Crimson Stone work for humans as well?
If all it gave you was power, that might be so.
What do you mean?
I've heard that it bears the curse of the vampires as well.
I see. So humanity would be lost.
There are no greater treasures for those who become vampires.
And Walter has the Ebony Stone in his possession?
That seems to be the case. It was supposedly lost along with the Crimson Stone.
But if the Ebony Stone reappeared, then the Crimson Stone...
may also have resurfaced. I pray that it is not here.
Interesting.
Welcome back.
Okay, now we should have an upgrade to our armor now.
What do you like?
Because we killed 4 of the 5 guardians. Or do I have to kill all 5 for the final one? Nope, Moonlight Plate. So it was Earth Meteor, Moonlight, and then Sun Plate's the final one. That's after we kill the last boss.
Is this one like anything else?
Let us buy it.
Anything else?
And I could literally
today?
Sell like.
Is this okay?
Yes, certainly.
Is that all? What would you like today? Is this fine? Would you like anything else?
Now I've got to buy the white bishop just to have it.
I appreciate your business.
Alright, learn something new about these stones. So the Ebony Stone, which is a black material, gives a vampire to create eternal night, which heavily enhances their powers. And then you have the Crimson Stone, which takes the soul of a vampire and converts it to strength. And the only downside is if a human uses it, they get the strength, but they get the whole kit and caboodle and become a vampire themselves. Interesting. All right. Four guardians down, 4 areas cleared. So when we return, we will tackle the final of Walter's dungeons, the Ghostly Theater. But till then, y'all be safe out there. Wear your mask. And take good care of each other, as I call this set. Catch you later.